Monday, it's raining. I think we're all tired of the rain, right? And we had rain on Friday and we've got rain again today and rain all weekend, but that's the way it is. Okay. So you're joining me live this morning. And I normally reserve these motivational mornings exclusively for my 6-week challengers. But for the next 2 weeks, I'm going to share my motivational mornings with you and show you what you're missing when you're not in my 6-week challenge. Our next one is launching on May 12th. Likely, if you are watching this video from one of a challenger's walls who have shared my video, make sure to ask them all about it. Get their experience. Find out if this is the right place for you and connect with me, because we are onboarding people right now into that challenge. So if you are watching live and I have valuable content for you, then please share it. I got a little hat shadow, eh? I should avoid that. Okay. Please share it live. And here we go, going into our topic of the day. What would you do if you had no choice? So in business, in life, with my health, with my training, I have a mindset where I train and operate my business as if I had no choice. So to give you an example, I look like I'm bald, eh? I'm not having a good hair day, my hat, the rain, whatever. Okay. So what's happened is, as a personal trainer, you're responsible to be happy, cheerful, motivational all the time, regardless whether you feel so or not, because people are paying you to be inspired, to be encouraged, to be motivated, and you have to operate emotionally on a level no matter what you're dealing with. So just to give you an idea, you know, about 4 years ago when I was making the decision to leave my ex and break up my family, I had to teach a spin class half an hour after signing the offer to buy the house that I'm in now. So I'm sitting in the parking lot of the gym. I'm sitting with my agent. And I know that by signing this piece of paper, that is the leap forward that I need to do to break up my family, which ultimately had to have been the best decision that I had to make. But can you imagine that the types of emotions that you might be feeling when you sign for a mortgage for a house? Can you pay for it? The commitment, what if they accept my offer? What if they accept my offer? And now I've got to move out of where I am and I've got to address all of these situations with my ex and the repercussions that come as a result of breaking up the family. And it's such an emotional roller coaster and it's so hard. And you got to walk into a room and instantly have a smile, be motivating, be excited, be encouraging, be helpful to other people when you really just feel like, you know, lying on the bed and escaping the world through Netflix, right? And I've had to encounter that many times. You know, I had a poodle and I had the dog for 13 years and she'd end up having a stroke, I believe, or something had happened. And she was literally dying in my hands, like literally falling apart, dying in my hands. And this was happening on a Saturday morning at 6:30 in the morning. And I had to go and teach a class at 7:00. And you could take the position where, you know, oh my God, my dog just died. I can't do anything and cancel your class at the last minute. Or you go, you teach your hour, you come back home and you deal with the situation. And during that hour, you've got to be motivating and inspiring. You can't go into a room saying my dog just died, because now the energy in the room is way down and they're, you know, questioning you. Is she okay? La, la, la. You just can't do that. So many, many times you're forced with a scenario where what would you do if you had no choice? You know, if you were in this situation right now, there's a decision at that time. You can totally break down, give up, be, I don't want to say weak, but let go, right? And not be strong. Or, you know, you can gather the strength that you have and you can push through and get through the situation. So in training, I train with that same mindset. So when I was size 16 and 180 pounds, instead of focusing on the workout and how long it would take for it to finish, and I'm bored and I'm tired and I don't feel like doing this and I'd rather be home, instead of putting my mind in that direction, I always put my mind to be, you know, like if I were doing a plank and I imagined that I had to hold that plank because if I didn't, I was going to fall down a cliff, right? Like I was holding on for dear life. And that's why I would say to myself, if I had no choice, if I had no option to let go, how long could I hold this plank literally to save my life, right? Hi, Jen. Hi, Emily. Hey, guys, say hi. Share your stories with me. I would love to hear your comments down below. I would love to interact with you. By all means, chit chat with me. Share my video live if you find that this is helpful to you and your family. Welcome, welcome. So when I was spinning or running or doing any kind of cardio, I always believed that I would have this mentality that if I had to save somebody's life or if I had to run away from danger, exactly how fast could I go to save my life or to prevent or save somebody from a fire or help or rescue, what have you. And so I believed anyways that with having that mindset while you were training, you weren't thinking about how tired you are. Because I think if you think you're strong, you're going to be strong. If you think you're tired and weak, that's the type of workout that you're going to end up having. And I believe that if you follow that mindset when it comes to your relationships and the, you know, you carry that mindset into your marriages by saying, you know, I need to do everything I can to make this marriage as beautiful and as loving as I can. And it doesn't matter if I've been married to them for 15 years and I'm bored or fighting all the time. By you taking on the position that you're strong, and what would you do if you had no choice and you had to stay married? You know, would you make it the best experience that you could make it? Or would you, you know, kick and scream and pout and be miserable every single day until the day you died? I mean, you can carry that mentality into everything that you're dealing with. So to top it all off, for those of you who've been following me for the last 2 weeks or so, I've had to start to deal with my neighbors again. My lovely neighbor next door loves to, he's a grumpy old man and he likes to call the city on me. And, you know, the city has been lurking with their car and looking at trying to evaluate, I guess. I don't know what they're doing. They haven't come to talk to me yet. But now I'm feeling, you know, that change is in the future for my business and how things are operated here. And you could sit down and panic and be all afraid and freak out, or you could say, okay, what would I do if I had no choice? So if the city came tomorrow and revoked my permit or whatever they felt that they had to do, well, I have a choice. I could be all brutal and nasty and think about how many different ways I can be annoying to my neighbor. And that thought has crossed my mind, believe me. But I don't wish to exert energy there. I wish to exert energy into seeing that iceberg. And if I were the Titanic and the captain of this ship, I would want to steer my ship away from that potential iceberg. So you work in the mindset right now where you're saying, if I had no choice, if tomorrow, you know, I my permit was revoked or whatever the case may be, how would I manage that? And I've come up with my solutions and I've shared it with my team and I've shared it with my challengers and we're all excited. I mean, it's an opportunity. It's not it's not a challenge. It's an opportunity and it's an opportunity for growth and we're excited about it. So it really depends on mindset, right? It depends on your mindset. And I believe that in business, in relationships, in life, in your workouts, and in everywhere possible, if you constantly have that mindset and that question of what would I do if I had no other choice? How would I handle this situation? Come up with the best, strongest answer that you can come up with. And you're good to go. You've got everything you need to solve your problems. Hopefully that was helpful for you today. We've just been pummeled with people like running into the 6-week challenge for May 12th. I'm trying to keep up with everybody. I've connected with so many. I must have talked to about 25 people yesterday. We've just had such a raging response as a result. You've seen the result pictures come on my wall. You've seen a lot of the testimonials hit the walls. You're seeing the results. You're seeing that the program speaks for itself. We've had a phenomenal amount of success. So do not delay, because I do promise you that my rates are going up in future challenges to come. So now in 4.0 is your time to jump on to this next challenge. You've seen all your friends go through it. You've seen the results that's been happening. And now you know it's time for you to take charge as well. There's no sense in putting a delay on it. Doesn't matter if you're traveling. Doesn't matter if it's summertime. Doesn't matter any other reason. Now is the time for you to jump in and join this challenge. So I look forward to meeting you. Hopefully today my content was valuable. If it was, please share it. Please comment with your stories down below. I want to know some of the things that you struggle with and how you make your life and your health non-negotiable. Awesome, guys. Awesome. I'm shutting down. We'll see you tomorrow on Tuesday. Bye for now, everybody.